Hello everyone, it's My Pampered Pet. This week for the collab, it is Do What You Want week. So I've decided to do a video on rabbit exercise, but mainly introducing you to rabbit jumping, which Jasper does. And sometimes Blossom has a go, but it's usually Jasper who is doing it and enjoying it the most. So yeah. The first thing I'm going to talk about is a rabbit run. You should always have a run for your rabbits, whether it's attached to a shed or a windy house where they live, or a hutch. A hutch should be 6 foot long by 2 foot deep by 2 foot high as a minimum for two rabbits. And it's always best to have a run attached, but if you can't, like me, as my rabbits, these three have free run of that shed, but sadly there's no room for the run to be attached. It's alright as long as the rabbits do get exercise all day and get to go out in the run all day. So yeah, these three come out at about 7 in the morning until it gets dark at night. So they have exercise all the time, which is really, really good for them. And if they're not in the run, because sometimes they're not, they're either having free range time, they're in the house with me getting exercise, or they're in the shed, which is the same size as the run, so they've got lots of room in there as well. And Blossom has a large hutch in the shed as well, and she's always in her run. Actually, sometimes I let her have free run of the shed, their three shed, and she does like to run around there because it's the same size as this run. So that's good for her. So yeah, you should always have a run. Minimum size is 6 foot by 4 foot, and that has to be 2 foot high. This run is slightly bigger. This one is 7 foot long, 5 foot wide, and 2 foot high. So this is a great size for rabbits. Then not only can they free range, go and run, and just get loads of exercise that way, but there's also another way to exercise that I have discovered, and that is called rabbit jumping. It's basically where rabbits jump over small hurdles for fun. Not all rabbits enjoy it, so you should never ever force them to go over by pushing them or pulling them or whatever. You should just let them see if they enjoy it. Jasper does rabbit jumping over little hurdles and stuff, and sometimes Blossom does it. I have tried it with Mischief and Tinkerbell, but they don't really enjoy it. They just sit there and look at it. So I don't make them do it. I wouldn't ever make any rabbit do it. It's up to them, like I said. I found out that Jasper enjoyed it because he used to live by himself, and he used to fill up his room with loads and loads of toys, and he used to jump over them really quickly, really fast. Even like the high ones, he used to jump straight over them. So I thought, well, I'll give this rabbit jumping thing a go. So I built up a few small hurdles using like carriers with like sticks across the top, and he really enjoyed that. So then I asked my dad to build me some jumps, and he did, which was very nice of him. And I will show you them later in the video. So I tried him jumping over them, and he really enjoyed it. And yeah, it's just gone on from there. He's been getting really high and really long and in jumping, and it's just fun for him. It's just something fun for him to do, keeps him occupied. But yeah, it's really fun, so I will introduce you to that now and tell you how to do it if you think your rabbit will enjoy it. You will know if your rabbit enjoys jumping because sometimes they'll binky over them like Jasper does, and that is just so, so cute. But if they're not binking over it, you'll know they're enjoying it because they'll be running over them really, really fast, just doing it on their own free will. So yeah, just give it a try if you think your bunny will like it, but never ever force them. Okay, so firstly you set up a little jump like that. Oh, Mischief's just demonstrating for you. And if you put it in a safe area, then you can see which rabbits like to go over it and jump and stuff. You should never start with a jump that's really, really high. You should always start with it being quite low. Oh my goodness, the wind! Well, you should always start with it being low because rabbits that jump quite big heights when they only just started learning, it isn't good for them and they can hurt themselves. So yes, start off low. I'm not sure how high this is, but not very high. Are you sniffing it, baby? And basically to make it, my dad made these. We just got a little block of wood and cut it into square, and then attached a big like wooden stick up it, and the same at that side. And then you get a pole, I've just put one at the bottom, and then there's these little screws. They're really safe. Bunnies can't hurt themselves on it. They're quite actually the soft screw. I just balance the get a pole up on it, and then if a bunny knocks it, then it falls straight off. So you should always make sure that if the bunny knocks the jump, that it should drop straight off. what are you doing? It's usually best to have jumps made out of like, well, just like this, but then have a little wooden block there, and you can balance like a wooden, balance a wooden stick across it. However, my dad made these, so I'm happy with these, but if I could have any more made, I would probably get wooden blocks attached and balance wooden sticks across instead of these plastic poles. But you should always make sure that there's no like sharp edges or anything like that. It needs to be really safe. So yeah, that's all you do to make a jump. And you see which bunnies enjoy it. Like I said, not all rabbits are interested. Whoa, the wind, the wind, the wind. So it's completely up to them whether they want to do it or not. Yeah, Jasper did it then. Oh, bless. So yeah, simply just set up a jump like that. Make sure it's really safe, no sharp edges, and see if your bunny goes over it. Then you can gradually make the jumps bigger. I've just added an extra pole on it. So if they want to try that out, they can. Jasper can actually jump all the way up to this high. You can jump 55 centimetres high, which is amazing. However, he will only do that when he wants to. I cannot force him, like I said. But it's up to him. So, hiya! They don't really seem interested today, I don't think. Well, they might do it in a minute. Are you going to do it? You can gently lift your rabbit up and put them just in front of the jump. And if they want to, they'll go over it. But you can also tempt them over with treats. Not too much, obviously, just a little bit of their favourite food or something. And they might hop over for that. As you saw then, Jasper just jumped over on his own free will. So he gets a treat. When they're just learning, it's best to reward them with a treat so that they know that, oh, that was fun, I get treats. But eventually, they'll just kind of, if they like it, they'll hop over anything in their way. And yeah, just really, really like it, like him. If they're just learning to jump, you could set them up on like a small path with like bars at the edge, and it's up to them. If they want to jump it, they'll jump it. If they don't, they'll either go under it or sit there. But if like you're in a bigger open space like this, make sure they have the option whether to go past it or not, because it's up to them. Heya! Heya! These two just cannot be bothered with this. They are so lazy, and if your rabbit's like that, then fair enough. Just leave them be, but if they want to jump, let them jump. Hey, you coming out? Coming out? Hello? Hello? You just jumped over again there. So yeah, they'll just jump whenever they want. And then eventually you can make a little course, so I'll do that now so you can see. So as you saw, he just jumped over. Excuse the weird noise I make. He seems to jump when I make that noise, which is a bit strange, but you know. Come on then. Nice new grass. They've like eaten all the grass in the run, so he's probably more interested in eating this grass right now. But that is absolutely fine. But if you're going to set up a course, obviously make sure it's in a safe area, because whirlwind. Great. Obviously, oh gosh, you don't want them running off, getting lost, getting hurt anywhere, or anything like that. My garden is practically bunny proof. There are a few places where they can get next door, but I'm here and there's only one bunny out, so, and he is very, very well behaved, so I know that he's going to be fine. But I also have a harness for him. I will just show you that now. Okay, so there's lots of different harnesses you can buy from the pet shops or online or wherever. These two styles are my favourite. Firstly, there is this one. This is called a H harness because when you turn it on its side, it looks like a H. Hey, Blossy. I don't use this one anymore because I have a better design, but these are sold in the UK, these H harnesses. And for beginners, they're really good and I would recommend these. This strap just goes around the belly. And this one goes gently around the neck. So that's the H harness. I decided to stop using these because I didn't like the fact that they went around the neck. And even though they're fine for bunnies, because you don't tug them, obviously. I didn't really like the fact that it went around his neck. So, yeah, I changed it. So then I went on an online shop. It was in Sweden. Was this shop. This is where they make them. And you can get a harness that, well, it fits to the exact size that you want. So I ordered this for Jasper. It's a really nice shop, you can get all different colours and designs and stuff. So I got this one. It's a shoulder harness. It's got a little buckle to fasten it. And yeah, I like this one. So obviously, as you probably gathered, because it's a shoulder harness, it goes around the shoulders and not the neck. I've also got a really long green lead with this one. And I like it when they have a longer lead because it means the bunnies have more freedom and can go wherever they like. Jasper doesn't mind the harnesses at all. He's fine in them. He was fine in this one, even though it went round his neck. But it was me who wanted to change it because I always want the best for my rabbits. And also, this is a softer material. It's just nice. To be honest, he hardly even notices he's got it on because he just acts so normal. He binkies in it and everything. Whereas this one, it's a bit of a harder material. It's alright. It doesn't hurt them or anything, but yeah, I just wanted this one. So I will put Jasper in this one so you can see him wearing it. You don't need these unless you're in an unsafe area, obviously. If you're in a secure area, then there's absolutely no point in wearing it. But if you are in an unsafe area, then you should put one of these on your bunny, preferably. But only if they like it, because some rabbits hate them, and if your rabbit hates it, then sorry, but you can't put one on it. It's just not fair at all. So only if they like them, or like don't mind them, then you should put them on. So yes, that is the harnesses. As you can see, Jasper now is wearing the harness. They fit round his shoulders, and that bit round his belly. He's really happy in it. As you can see, he's just normally casually eating the leaves. So yeah, that's just that, and it's got the extra long lead like that. And you should never, ever, ever, ever drag a rabbit. You should just follow them and let them go wherever they like. And sometimes Jasper does jump in these. I know I said that my garden was pretty much secure and there's no point wearing them in a secure area. But sometimes when my cat is in the garden, even though you probably wouldn't hurt them, I don't want to risk it. So he usually wears this if my cat's out. And also if there's any neighbourhood cats around or anything like that. Or if I just feel like it's safer for him to wear it. So that's what this is for. But as you can see, he's just going wherever he likes. So I'll set up a jump, or them two, and I'll show you him jumping in the harness if he wants to, obviously, because he might not want to. Okay, so I've just set up the camera. It's the best I can do right now. So I will see if he wants to jump or not whilst in the harness.
Good boy.
So as you can see there, he did that quite happily, and now he just wants to eat the grass again. So he didn't mind doing that, but I'm going to take him off the harness now and just let him jump freely and run around the garden or whatever. It's up to him what he wants to do now, but that was just to show you that they can jump happily in harnesses as well. So as you can see there, Jasper did that all by himself. I wasn't even next to him, because sometimes I just walk next to him to make sure that if he like runs off, I can scoop him up quickly so he don't get into danger or anything. But he's absolutely fine. He's been jumping for almost a year now. In a few days, it's going to be a year. I think we started on the 2nd of April last year, I can't remember now. And he's done really, really well. So I'm going to add in some clips at the end so you can see how much he's improved in the past year. So I hope you'll like that. But thank you for watching. Please subscribe to the collab. Bye!